Hi everyone, my name is Heather and I'm the person behind Happy Puppy Truffles. Today I wanted to share with you guys a fun project where you can use origami to make your own personalized wall clock. Now, if you have access to like a Deco or a dollar store, you probably can get a hold of some wall clocks that are super cheap and flimsy and plasticky and maybe don't even keep time all that great sometimes. I know these kind of don't last all that well, but there are fun things that you can do with these, of course. If you take them apart, you can change the face of everything here and make your own kind of personalized gift. And it's a great way to kind of showcase some fancy origami paper that you might have. You could just obviously simply just make a circle here and just smack it down in there, and then you have a fancy little clock. You could put some plain paper and then put tiny little pieces, you know, at 12, 3, 6, and 9, or just at 12. Lots of different ways that you can approach this. I was going to show you guys a couple of ways where you can put a camellia flower or a medallion inside and make it the same size to fit into the clock. But when you do this, of course, you need to use just a tiny bit of math. We're going to need to keep in mind, for example, with a camellia flower, if you look at the traditional video tutorials, they all tell you what the finished dimensions of each of these flowers is going to be. And I went ahead, I've already made both of them, but I can kind of show you guys here. The camellia generally is, you use a piece of paper in my tutorials, it's 15 by 15, and then the finished dimensions are 8 by 8. So if you take the concept of ratios, I know this sounds like scary math, but it's actually not that scary. We're just going to use some fractions. Both of these dimensions are the same, so I can just do either way. 15 piece of paper gives us an 8 finish. And then I know that I can measure the diameter of this area here and know how big I want it to be. And in my case, the diameter of this watt clock is 13 centimeters. So if you make this X and then you do cross multiplication, so 15 times 13 equals 8 times X, divide both sides by 8, and that'll give you the value that you need for X, which in this case is 24.375. So I know it can be kind of a little off-putting to have to do math, but it can be really helpful because you can use the same technique if you know, for example, that you want to use a camellia for just the 12, 3, 6, and 9 section and you know what you want it to be 2 centimeters big. For example, you can do the exact same thing. You can say 15 over 8 equals X over 2. 15 times 2 equals 8X, and then divide both sides by 8. And in this case, it's 3.7. Let me see how I did the math. I have it on my notes. 3.75. But basically, it's just encouraging you guys that if you can do that basic little bit of math, you can really adjust any kind of origami down to be the right size so that it can fit into any kind of project. So in my case, I used that math to figure out for the camellia for this size. And then I also had made a medallion. And I'll show you guys some of the things I'm going to do to kind of adjust it a little bit. But I'm sure the chances of you guys having the same dimensions of a clock as mine are pretty low. So I don't want to make a big deal about using this particular size paper. Just want you to be reminded that by using that concept of making a proportion between two fractions, you can get the numbers that you need. So, but the big thing too to look at here, of course, is we want to be able to pop open this little guy. And, you know, everybody's clocks are going to be put together differently. This one, you just kind of separate the face from the back here with these little screws. These don't usually, you know, pop out very easily. You kind of have to just leave things, you know, together. Everybody's clocks are going to be a little different of how much they can come apart. The cheaper they are, the less likely they are to be able to be taken apart well. So you're going to have to keep that in mind. But I'm just taking this off here. There's a plastic paper piece or glass even. Feel that size? It's even glass. Wow, that's fancy. Put that to the side. And in this case, I'm just going to be, it could be a little daunting, but you're just pulling this guy out and then taking off these guys too, the hands. They all have little grooves of where they rest so that they can tail time properly. Now, one of the things you have to take into consideration is how deep everything is here. This is not a very deep space, so you want to keep something that's fairly flat, or you'll have stuff that bumps into itself and it won't work for a clock. So this, in this case, for this clock, it looks like this is actually something that maybe can get removed if we're looking at it right. Let's see here. I don't know. Is it going to actually peel up? It's pretty glued down there. I'm going to try to just take it off. You do have the... You could leave this on if you wanted to, or you could take it off like I'm doing, just to keep it out of the way. You do have the general, you know, battery section in the back here to remind you of what is the top part and the place here. So we know that's 12. It's good to keep those things in mind so that you don't run into any trouble. I made this just a tad bit big because I wanted to be able to just fold down the edges a little bit and create, hopefully, a nice little snug piece here. I could also just let it, maybe I'll just leave it like that and let it kind of stick up on the sides like that. That kind of looks cool. You can kind of just play around with it and see what you're left with when you put it all in here. Just sort of depends on how you want things to look. What I did when I made the camellia is that I went ahead, it's even still sticky down there. I can use the glue from before. That's cool. I just cut this little circle in the middle by just folding things in half and then in half again and just snipping off the edge. And it gave me a little bit of a hole. You could try to use a hole punch, but that can be a little tricky, I know. Now, I want to be careful, though, because I've got these little pockets of space here that could cause a trouble for the hands as they go going around the clock. They might get stuck in there. That wouldn't work very good. So I want to make sure that I glue everything down really good here. And you know, this part can be frustrating if you don't like using glue, but this is a craft project. So I'm just going to put a whole bunch of glue here, or you could use some double-sided tape. I just want to try to keep it so that I have the least amount of you know, weight to everything, because I do really want to keep this as flat and as thin as possible. And you can even go ahead and go in here and try to get these parts to And it's just about keeping this as snug and tight down at the bottom as we can with everything. And you can also, of course, take advantage of having it being under something heavy for a while so that it can be smashed down really good so that you don't run into these kinds of troubles too much. But if I really get a lot of glue on there, hopefully I could get this to snug down really good. And obviously you could use the backside too if you wanted to, but and you know, it helps to make nice good creases to keep everything really straight. And then you do have to consider too, with time and depending on where you live, I know I live where there's a lot of humidity, these kinds of projects can kind of poof out weird later on, and you might need to adjust them if you notice that the glue is not sticking anymore or that something's popping out weird. So keep that in mind as you do this. But that's kind of what we're looking at here. And then if you just go ahead and stick that into your clock, you can get a nice completed clock. And like I said, I'm just going to kind of look at it here and because mine's just tiny little bit big, then I can have a little bit of this sticking up kind of around the edges to create sort of a nice little snug finished piece. Now, I'm not going to put the glue down yet because I do want to show you guys with the other kind of style, but you can then, of course, put some glue back here so that this will stay down. And then when you put all of this on again, you just follow, put the, no, in my case, you put the, usually this is the way it works, you put the hour hand down first. And if this looks like it's bent, you can kind of pop it up a little bit so that it'll have a clean path as it goes around. These do sometimes get a little bent as you're pulling them apart. And then put this one in. And then we have the second hand as well. And that just kind of gives you a nice little finished cool clock after you put the face on that you can use then to decorate your house or your office. So that's with one way with using the cute little camellia flower. And then I wanted to just show you guys also using the medallion as well. And in this case too, you're going to have to kind of make some adjustments. This is already sticking because of the glue that was on the bottom before. There we go. Some strong glue. I don't even have to put any on there. That's nice. You can steal a step that way. I have the medallion that I've already made here. And what I've done, you could choose how to do this depending on the kind of paper you used. This kind of looks pretty cool. The backside of this paper looks pretty cool. It has a neat, like, kind of batik quality to it. And of course, I'm going to be folding these sides down before I put it in. And I want to eliminate some of this because it's also kind of in the way. And so what you can do with this particular origami is you can go ahead and take the tips of this first part here and just tuck it all the way into this corner. And you should be able, if you put it all the way into the corner, you should be able to get it really nice and snug with that edge. And you should barely be able to see it just sticking out here. And if I do that for all of these, and then I fold back, I'll be able to eliminate any of the, you know, it'll actually snag and get folded back on its own, so I won't need to worry about doing any extra gluing. I can just get it tucked away with some folds here. And this particular one, you know, you can kind of play around with depending on, of course, what you kind of result you're looking for. But I'm kind of looking for this, if I can get this tucked under. And I'm also going to tuck this part too. And in this case, I can only just go halfway, but it is going to help eliminate some of the amount of little pieces that are sticking out because some of those are harder to keep down. So I'm just going to kind of make it so that the face has enough room, and then hopefully the hands of the clock won't run into too much obstruction if we do it this way. So I just fold underneath here. This basically just brings this tip right to the back of everything when you do this. And you can kind of keep an eye on stuff if you need to make it, try to make it straight. So I get that kind of folded back for everything, and then I can fold these parts down too. And this is one too that really benefits from being underneath something for a while so that we can have a little bit of time to keep it flat. But I'm just going to go ahead and of course put some glue, try to put it underneath all this and on these tabs as I pull them back so that I can eliminate some of it. I don't think we're going to run into any trouble. Let's see here. Yeah, we might run into a little trouble on the edges there. So any place that I can try to glue it back, I'm going to try to do that so that I can eliminate some of the trouble of it being out and snagging on things. And like I said, you can always use double-sided tape if you want, but I think it tends to work a little better if you just use good old-fashioned glue here. The edge, so I do kind of get kind of snagged on it like that a little bit. But so this is kind of how things look when it's all flattened out good. And then again here you can just kind of take a second to kind of fold some stuff in here to be able to create a hole. And you don't necessarily need to fold all of it. You can see here I just folded just the tips area here. And I can just cut off a little bit and it'll give me the space I need in the middle. And again, I made this to be fairly snug. I didn't really want any extra sticking out anywhere if I could help it. So I will wind up just kind of bringing up the edges just a tiny bit as I smoosh this down in here so I can kind of, guys, see as we get this in here that the edges do stick up just a tiny bit. And once you've got everything in there, then you want to make sure you know kind of where top of things are. I'll put this hour hand here and the minute hand. And the second hand. And then you just put the pieces back together again with the lid part. But that kind of gives you the finished piece, and you can see how cool that looks with the paper in there. And like I said, this can be just sort of a fun project that you can do with lots of different kinds of papers. And I hope you guys can find some fun ways to kind of use origami with clocks to create your own kind of pretty decorative clock. These make great gifts. And just with a bit of math and a little bit of practice, you can make them of all sizes and have a lot of fun with them. So I'll have some more fun projects to share with you guys in the days to come. Thanks again always so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!